In addition topic, we have solved the word problems on addition. In subtraction topic, we have solved the word problems on subtraction. But today, now we are going to solve the word problems that have the both operations, means addition and subtraction. These both operation we have to do in the same example. Okay, so for solving such a type of example, you should read that word problem properly. See the sequence and which things are given in the word problems and which things that we have to find out. Understand that things properly so you can solve that problem properly. Okay, so see, now we will solve this word problem. Read the word problem. You have to read the word problem twice, okay, and understand which things are given. Okay, so see the word problem. The population of the village is 7410. Okay, the population of the village is 7410. If there are 2974 women and 1450 children, how many men are there in the village? Okay, so after reading this example, we know that the population of the village means total number of people. Population of the village means total number of people is this much, 7410. Okay, and if there are 2974 women. Okay, so how many women are living in that village? 2974. And how many children are living in that village? 1450. And we have to find out how many men are living in that village. Okay, so step by step write the given information in the example, and then it is very simple to solve. Okay, so see, first thing is given, that is the population of the village. So write solution: total population of the village is 7410. Okay, this much peoples are living in that village. Okay, then number of women in the village. So how many women are living there? 2974. So right here, 2974. Then next step, how many children are living there? 1450. So right, number of children living in the village is equal to 1450. Okay, so now in the example, the numbers of women and children are given. Now add the two numbers, number of women and number of children. Okay, next step is add these two numbers. So you will get how many total women and children are living in that village. Okay, so number of women and children in village is equal to 2974 women and 1450. Okay, now do this addition: 2974 plus 1450. Add these two numbers, so you will get the total number of women and children. Okay, so 4 plus 0, 4, 7 plus 5, 12, 2 right here, 1, carry, 9 plus 4, 13, plus 1, 14, 4 right here and 1 carry, then 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so there are 4,424 women and children are living in that village. Okay, so right, 4,424 women and children are living in that village. But they ask how many men are living in that village. Okay, so what to do here? Now we have the total population of the village and we have the total number of women and children living in that village. So now if you subtract the total number of women and children from the population of the village, you will get the how many men are living in that village. Okay, so now subtract 4424 from total population, so you will get the number of men. Okay, so number of men in the village is equal to total population is 7410 minus number of women and children 4424. Now do this subtraction, so you will get the number of men. Okay, so do this subtraction here, 7410 minus 4424. Okay, now solve this subtraction example. 0 minus 4 not possible, so cut this one right here, 0 right here, 10, 10 minus 4 6, 0 minus 2 not possible, so take 1 from 100 from 4, so here 3 remains, here 10, 10 minus 2 8, 3 minus 4 not possible, cut this 7 right here, 6 right here, 13, 13 minus 4 9 and 6 minus 4 2. Okay, so in that village 2986 men are living. So write the last statements. Hence what they ask, how many men are living in the village, so make the statement of this sentence. Okay, so hence there are 2986 men in the village, okay. So like this you have to solve this example. Okay, read that question and understand which things are given and which things we have to find out. Next example, Nisha bought 654 orange sweets and 126 pineapple sweets to distribute on her birthday. Which sweets were bought more and how many? Okay, I am reading this question again. Okay, Nisha bought 654 orange sweets and 126 pineapple sweets to distribute on her birthday. Which sweets were bought more and how many? By observing this question, you can tell orally which sweets she bought more in number. So you can tell she bought orange sweets more in number, because this number is big, this number is smaller than 654. So she bought orange sweets more in number. To get how much orange sweets she bought more, you have to take the difference of these two numbers, so you will get how many orange sweets she purchased more in number. Okay, so write the information that is given in the question. Okay, number of orange sweets is equal to 654, number of pineapple sweets 126, and which sweets she bought more in number, that is orange sweets. Okay, now how much or how many orange sweets she purchased more in number, so you take the difference of these two numbers, means subtract 126 from 654, so you will get that number. Okay, so next, number of orange sweets more than pineapple sweets is equal to 654 minus 126. Okay, now do the subtraction, 654 minus 126. 6, okay. 4 minus 6, not possible. So, cut this 5, right here 4, right here 14, 14 minus 6, 8, then 4 minus 2, 2, 6 minus 1, 5, okay. So, she purchased or she bought 528 orange sweets more than pineapple sweets, okay. So, write the last statement, hence, she bought 528 orange sweets more than pineapple sweets. Like this, you have to solve this example. Dear student, next example. Mr. Kumar had to cover a distance of 3450 kilometer. He covered 1458 by car and 568 kilometer by bus. Okay, how many distance did he cover by train? Okay, so now after reading this example, we know that Mr. Kumar had to cover total distance 3450 kilometer. Out of that 1458 kilometer distance he covered by car and 568 kilometer distance he covered by bus, and we have to find out how much distance he covered by train. Okay, so write the information that is given in the word problem sequence wise. Okay, so total distance he covered, that is 3450 kilometer. Okay, next thing, distance covered by car. Okay, so how much distance he covered by car, that is 1458 kilometer distance he covered by car. Then next, how much distance he covered by bus, that is 568 kilometer. Okay, so now next step, add the distance he covered by car and he covered by bus. Okay, so next step, distance covered by car and bus is equal to 1458 kilometer plus 568 kilometer. Now do the addition of these two numbers. I am doing here 1458 plus 568. Okay. Now add these two numbers, 8 plus 8, 16, 1 carry, 5 plus 6, 11 plus 1, 12, to write here 1 carry, 4 plus 5, 9 plus 1, 10, 1 carry here, 1 plus 1, 2. Okay. So he covered 2026 kilometer by using bus and car. Okay, so right here that value is equal to 2026 kilometer. Okay, so now we know that he covered total distance 3450, and we have the total distance he covered by car and bus is equal to 2026. If you subtract the distance covered by car and bus from the total distance, you will get the distance he covered by the train. Okay, so distance covered by train is equal to total distance is 3450 kilometer minus 2026 kilometer. Okay, so now do this subtraction, so you will get the distance covered by the train. Okay, so do this subtraction, 3450 minus 2026. Okay, 0 minus 6 not possible, so cut this 5, write here 4, write here 10, 10 minus 6 4, 4 minus 2 2, 4 minus 0 4, and 3 minus 2 1. Okay, so this much distance he covered by train. Okay, 1424 kilometer distance he covered by the train. Okay, so write the last statement, how many distance did he covered by train. So write the statement, hence 1424 kilometer distance he covered by train. Okay, like this you have to solve this example. Next example, the sum of three numbers is 8010. Okay, if two of them are 2768 and 1587, find the third numbers. Okay, so there are three numbers. Okay, and the sum means the addition of that three number is 8010, and first two numbers are given here. First number is 2768 and second number is 1587, and we have to find out the third number. Okay, so what to do here? First, we know the sum of three numbers, means we know the sum means addition of that three number. Okay, and we have the two numbers, only we have to find out the third numbers. Okay, so what to do here? Subtract the sum of the two numbers from the sum of the three numbers, so you will get the third number. Okay, so write the things that are given in the question. Sum of the three numbers is 8010. Okay, sum of the three numbers is 8010. Okay, so first number is 2768, so write that first number 2768. Okay, and the second number is 1587. Now what to do? Add these two numbers, so you will get the sum of two numbers. Okay, so sum of two numbers is equal to add these two numbers, 2768 plus 1587. Okay, so add these two numbers, 2768 plus 1587. 8 plus 7, 15. 1 carry. 6 plus 8, 14 plus 1, 15. 1 carry. 7 plus 5, 12 plus 1, 13. 3 right here, 1 carry. 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4. Okay, so 4355 is the sum of first two numbers. Now we have to find out the third numbers, means now subtract the sum of two numbers from sum of three numbers, so you will get third number. Okay, so third number is equal to sum of three numbers is equal to 8010 minus sum of two numbers is equal to 4355. Okay, now subtract these two numbers, 8010 minus 4355. Do this subtraction, 0 minus 5 not possible, so cut this one, write here 0, write here 10, 10 minus 5 5, 0 minus 5 not possible, here also 0, so regroup this 8, write here 7, write here 10. Okay, now here 0 minus 5 not possible, so take 100 from 1000. Okay, so write here 9, and 100 means 10 10, so write here 10. 10 minus 5 5, 9 minus 3 6, and 7 minus 4 3. 3655 is the third number, so write the last statement, hence 3000 655 is the third number. Example, Sumit has rupees 5750. He purchased a table for rupees 1640 and a chair for rupees 758. How much money is left with him? Okay, so Sumit has total 5750 rupees. Okay, out of this rupees, he purchased a table for rupees 1640 and he purchased one chair for rupees 758. And now how much money is left with him after his shopping? Okay, so now write the things that are given in the question. So first thing is given, that is the amount, total amount or total money with Sumit is equal to rupees 5750. Okay, the next thing that is given, that is the cost of the table. Okay, he purchased one table and the cost of that table is 1640. So write the cost of table is equal to rupees 1640. Then next things that he purchased, that is the chair, and what is the cost of the chair? 758 rupees. Okay, so write the cost of chair 700 means rupees 758. Okay, next, now add these two amounts. Okay, so you will get the total money spent on these two things. Okay, so cost of table and chair is equal to rupees 1640 plus rupees 758. Okay, now add these two numbers, 1640 plus 758. Okay, so 0 plus 8 8, 4 plus 5 9, 6 plus 7 13, 1 carry here, 1 plus 1 2. Okay, so he spent 2398 rupees to buy the chair and the table. Okay, so right here 2398 rupees he spent to purchase chair and the table. Now how much money is left with him? So we have the total money. Okay, and now subtract this 2398 from total money. So you will get the money left with him. Okay, so write money left with him is equal to rupees 5750 minus 2398. Okay, now do this subtraction, 5750 minus 2398. Okay, 0 minus 8 not possible, so write here 4, write here 10 minus 8 2, 4 minus 9 not possible, cut this 7, write here 6, write here 14 minus 9 5, 6 minus 3 3, and 5 minus 2 3. Okay, so this much money left with Sumit. Okay, so write last statements, hence rupees 3352 left with him. Okay, like this you have to solve this example.